no U-turn signs. We better observe that because Greenville's finest is on the trail here. Rumor is that one of the buildings up here at J.B. White may be moving into it sometime soon. There's also a Ritz Theater. There are a number of theaters here on Main Street. Now, it's at the corner of East North Street and Main. There's a Pete's Lunch counter right next door, and that's some good eating, let me tell you. Looks like there's a Shirley Temple movie playing. And as we cross and keep going north, we're headed up toward the Otteray Motel, or hotel, I should say. Now, the Otteray is one of the other hotels here in Greenville. Gives you a beautiful, beautiful picture here on the postcard. And great view from their porch, which is very well known. It can get very busy in the 30s here in downtown Greenville, as you might expect, especially during Christmas season. And as you pass the Otteray and head up a little north, there's the Carolina Theater. Now, I don't want to park because parking's 15 cents. That's pretty steep down here. But we'll keep going. Why, at one time, Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer sent their lion, Leo, the one that roars at the beginning of the movies, he came through town. And now the Carolina not only has movies that play, and I should say, among the kids, one of the most popular westerns, especially on Saturdays, Colonel Tim McCoy is quite popular. There's another guy named John Wayne that's doing pretty good. Not only show movies, but also have a stage in the Carolina Theater. It'll seat over 1,200 people. And sometimes local stage, like dance classes, different forms of entertainment, but sometimes national acts as well, like Jimmy Dorsey came through with his orchestra. And they're still talking about Fats Waller coming to town in his big limousine. As we go on north, we're going to come up on Springwood Cemetery. Now, it started out as a family cemetery, but by 1829, it was being used as public cemetery. Quite a big cemetery. A lot of folks from Furman are buried here, faculty and members of the Furman family. There are also a lot of unknown Confederate dead, and there are soldiers from the Great War who got the influenza, who were training over at Camp Sevier. Richland is very close to Springwood Cemetery. And it goes over towards Stone Avenue in Richland, too. And it's the black cemetery in town. And many of the very well-known black citizens in town are buried in Richland. Well, as we continue north, we're coming up on the Park School building. Now, the library at one time was on Main Street back the other side of the Otteray. It's about the center of the block. And their lease came up, and so they moved over on College Street, rented a garage for a while, former garage, and then the rumor has it that they're moving to this Park School building. It's right on Main Street, and that would be wonderful. That's a nice building indeed. Now, I was just looking over a few books that were popular back in the 30s, saying, in 1930, Cimarron, 1931, The Good Earth by Pearl S. Buck, let's see, 37, Gone with the Wind, and I might leave this list out if you'd like to see it, Nonfiction, How to Win Friends and Influence People, how about that, Northwest Passage. That's the kind of books that are going on. Let's see where we're headed here. Oh, the Trinity Lutheran Church is just across from the library on Main Street. We'll keep on going down the hill. Oh, McPherson Park is just down on the right. Beautiful park. Got some nice pools. Ducks often in the pools there. You know, while we're looking at parks, let's head around and we'll turn back down Main. We won't do a U-turn for sure, but then head out East North Street. I noticed the baby house is up here on the left, just as we get to Church Street. If you're cold back there in the rumble seat, there is a blanket back there. This is one of the early homes in Greenville. It's been in the same family. I believe the lady died just, we'll have to see if it stays in the same family, but in 1938. We'll turn on Church Street and head over to Christ Episcopal Church. This is the oldest organized church in Greenville as far as the congregation. And again, guess who donated the land? Vardery Mackey. This church was built about 1852. It's the oldest church still standing in the town of Greenville. Quite a cemetery to have. And many of the graves are very well-known Greenvillians, such as Benjamin F. Perry, who was the mayor, and he was also the newspaper editor, and Vardery Mackey himself is buried there as well. We'll keep on going down, and we're going to turn on Washington Street and head down to Cleveland Park. Some of the ladies have turned an old rock quarry into a garden down there. It's beautiful. Now, one project that money has been received from the government to do is to dredge the bed of the Reedy River and clear it out. And they say, somebody wrote that it's going to alleviate the traditional smell of the river. And that's one smell that, or one tradition that they don't want to continue. They've also built a swimming pool down in Cleveland Park. Now, in 1939, in the summer, the polio epidemic hit Greenville, and they closed swimming pools, and children could not go out in crowds. No Sunday schools, couldn't go to the movie, couldn't go where large crowds were. They didn't know exactly what caused polio, but they knew that people got it in the summertime and in groups. Let's head on. We're not far from the Lanoue House. It's a beautiful old house from 1870s is when it was built. Quite a mansion.
Is that the Gasaway Mansion?
No, it's the Lanoue Norwood home. Lanoue was a textile man. We'll head over to the Gasaway Mansion though. In fact, what we'll do is turn on the Crescent Avenue. Now this house is not, how can I put it, looks like a fairly plain white southern farmhouse, so to speak, but it is a very important house. It's a Donaldson house. And Mr. Donaldson, who bought it. The house was actually built during the Civil War, and the owner moved, and then the house actually went up for auction in about 1867 or so, and Mr. Donaldson bought it. He was he went to West Point, and he actually served on the frontier out west, served in the Philippines, traveled all over the world. He's buried up in Arlington National Cemetery. His son was also a military man, John Donaldson, and he was an ace during the Great War. He shot down 7 German airplanes. Unfortunately, he was killed in an airplane crash in 1930. But we still call it Donaldson House, and there's a little elementary school about a block over on Pendle Avenue called Donaldson Elementary.